He was to experience the truth of the saying that the worst foes a man can have are those of his own household. If he could have trusted anyone, it would have been the Austrian prince who ruled in Tuscany. But not only did Leopold of Habsburg, who reigned at Florence, refuse the urgent demand of Metternich to dispense with the services of his liberal counselor Cosimo Ridolfi, but as time went on, he showed an increasing sympathy with many of the objects of the reformers. Soon a crisis arose which tried to the utmost the patience of the nations. Under pressure put upon him by his subjects, a pressure which he had provoked by his unwisdom, the Duke of Lucca had taken advantage of a clause in the Treaty of Vienna to resign his territories to Leopold of Tuscany. The same clause which enabled Leopold to accept the transfer necessitated the surrender by him of the district of Pisano to the Duke of Modena. The people of that district refused to be transferred, whereupon the Duke, summoning to his aid the troops of Marshal Radetzky, marched into the town of Pisano and massacred the inhabitants. Troops of the same nation shortly afterwards occupied Parma, and although the Duke of Modena was forced to yield his pretensions to the towns of Pontremoli and Bagnone, the transaction better known as King Bona, had been characterized by a tyranny of the worst description. His subjects had shown their sense of its harshness by spasmodic outbreaks. They had risen at Aquila in 1841, at Cosenza in 1844, and as I have previously reported, at Calabria in July of the same year. In every instance, the insurgents had been suppressed, scaffold and prisons had restored momentary order. But the spirit which inspired those outbreaks defied the tyranny of the monarch, and as the repression of all that makes life valuable to a man became more severe, the resolution to buy freedom at whatever cost became more fixed. This resolution developed into action at Messina the 1st September 1847. The rising at Messina was repressed, and as usual, its repression was sealed with blood. But failure had not deprived the Italian and Sicilian wooers of freedom of their courage. Naples rose, Palermo rose, Ferdinand was driven from every place in Sicily except the castle of Messina, and he was forced, 29th January, to grant a